the first thing to understand about biosimilars is that they are biological products. A biological product is a very complex product. It's produced in a living system, such as a bacteria, a yeast, or a cell. There's some inherent variability that's with that because it's a biological system, it's a living system. It's more difficult to control in the same way as you would something that's going to be chemically synthesized. Again, these are complex molecules that are more complicated to manufacture than what people typically think of in terms of a small molecule. And that does make the data package a little bit bigger than you would expect for something that would be a generic to a chemically synthesized product. For biological products, we didn't have an abbreviated approval pathway. So the only way to come to market was to have that full data package, which can be very expensive to develop those products. And you see that reflected in the cost of the products in the marketplace. So what happened in 2010 was that Congress signed a law that allowed FDA to approve biosimilar products. For folks that use biological therapies, either prescribers or patients, it's well known that these are very expensive products. So it's good to have that competition in the marketplace and ultimately that cost reduction to patients. A biosimilar product in the law that FDA needs to follow describes a biosimilar product as being a product that's highly similar to the product they're comparing themselves to that we call the reference product, and that would have been that originator product. So it has to be highly similar, and there has to be no clinically meaningful differences between the two products. So we look at the structure of the products, we make those comparisons about the structure, how they're functioning. So that first step is to do that analytical comparison or the structural and functional comparison to make sure that their structure is the same, they look the same, has the same primary sequence, same type of quaternary, tertiary structure that helps in its function. After that, we want to look more closely at whether or not there's clinically meaningful differences between the products, because those analytical comparisons can tell you so much about the molecule and so much about the comparison between the molecules and how similar they are, but there is some residual uncertainty that would remain about how it would perform in the body, in a patient. So we look for additional studies, including what's called pharmacokinetics, and that's the exposure in the body. Does it release in the body the same way? Does it circulate in the body the same way? Is it getting to the same place in the same way to exert its clinical effect? And then we can look at other types of clinical tests with different types of endpoints where we would be interested in certain populations or certain diseases. We also look at differences in safety, making sure that it has the same safety profile between the products. And this all leads to the assessment that there's no clinically meaningful differences between the products, that there's an expectation that when FDA approves a product, it will work the same way in the body, whether they take the reference product or they take the biosimilar. There's no clinical difference between the products. So FDA will not approve a biosimilar product if they don't feel that the data supports that they're biosimilar and ultimately that the products can be labeled for safe and effective use. So while the data packages between a biosimilar product and a reference product or an originator product are different, and that's where the concept of an abbreviated approval pathway comes in. FDA's standard to approve a product and be able to label a product as safe and effective for its intended use is the same regardless of the pathway. So the healthcare community and the patient community should have confidence that FDA is applying those same rigorous standards in terms of approving products and ensuring that they are safe and effective.